been traveling on missions around the world for 20 years now. But when I said yes to God and yes to Cambodia, God poured out the Holy Spirit on me as never before. And just like our theme says, rush, that's what happened to me. The power of the Holy Spirit rushed through my mind, through my spirit, through my body, and empowered me to do things I never imagined that I'd be able to do. And in the last year, our missions team has traveled twice to Cambodia, and I'm thrilled to tell you that the biogas digester works. That when we were there in November, we were eating food cooked on a gas stove. The gas came from the biogas digester.
Before the break of that first dawn, you wrote the secrets of the world. You filled the ancient skies with your voice and light.
But along the way, the people who traveled on the mission trip found out that God could use them in ways that they never, ever expected.
I'm bringing glory to the God above, full of truth and endless love. He who is.
We had the opportunity to teach a lesson of Noah's Ark with the kids. And at one moment, we asked one of the kids if they wanted to pray, and this young lady came up and she decided she wanted to pray, and she prayed such a beautiful prayer. When we noticed that she was in the corner and she was not playing with them, Kathy, one of our team members, went over to her just to talk to her, and then noticed that her arm was broken. So Kathy and I decided that we were gonna wrap her arm there, we were gonna make a tourniquet for her there, and kind of help her mend her arm. Tears were running down her arms, and I was holding her hand and I was just praying with her, and she just took it so bravely, and we were able to wrap her arm. We were able to mint to give her this really cool bright pink cast, and we prayed with her afterwards. And I just thought, if we weren't there, if we didn't come to Cambodia, her arm may have been broken for many months and she may have lost the use of that arm. But because we decided that we were going to come to a rural village in Cambodia, she has an opportunity to use that arm again.
He who is and was and always will be. I surrender to the one, gentle and most powerful. All the things you are, you've chosen to be.
One day we are at the railroad track, where we fed about 340 children that I was assessing and taking care of wounds and medications and healing, where I noticed that there was an elderly man standing at the corner of the van trying to get my attention. And he said to him that his foot was burning and was very itchy and it was bothering him and hurting him. So I washed his foot. I noticed that he had a really bad case of athlete's foot. I took off my sock, put it on him, took off my other sock, and told them to alternate them, wash them and alternate it, but keep that foot clean. And giving him my socks, God was taking care of my needs back in the States and in my trial. The verdict at the end of my trial was that the judge awarded me my home and was given to me scot-free. So I did God's work and he did mine.
As an educator, I teach British literature. I'm not really a construction person, however, I'm always willing to do what's necessary to get the job done. Sopai is his name. Sopai was very aloof, distant, you might even say he was a bit angry. However, over the period of time we were there in Cambodia, as we worked together and showed the love of Christ, as we were saying our farewells, we saw Sopai. He said to me as I was about to hug his neck, "I happy." That touched me. That in that moment, I saw the scripture become tangible. I thought about the hope and how Christ said in Romans, it is the love of Christ that is shed abroad in the hearts of men that brings down the walls. I saw how Sopai changed from a distant, aloof young man to one who embraced and loved. To think that Christ would use me, his hands and feet, in the earth to touch men's hearts. That is what changed me and my Cambodia trip.
And one of the awesome things that happened for me is, as we were getting there, we were told the boys and young men probably wouldn't share their stories with us as to why they were in Teen Challenge. But what happened is, as we were doing construction and working with him, Taylor said, "Hey, Crystal, weren't you in Teen Challenge?" And I was able to share my story with some of the boys, and what happened throughout that day was they slowly made their way to me and started to tell me their stories. And I was able to give them hope and to let them know that being in Teen Challenge wasn't the end, but it was really the beginning, and that they had no idea the future that God had for them. And if they stuck with the program and finished it, God would be able to do amazing things in their lives. And it was just such a wonderful opportunity for me to be able to share that with them.
We have not only partnered with Teen Challenge, but because of the giving and the generosity of the people at Trinity Church, we were able to help an organization called Cambodian Care open a school in a slum. Now, that particular slum is known as a place where young girls can be bought for sex trafficking. And through the establishment of this school, these kids are no longer on the street. So imagine 3 months ago, these kids had never been to school ever in their life. They look forward to a life of begging on the street. Of 500 people living in the slum, none of the people had heard the name of Jesus. But I'm happy to tell you, when we were there in November, the school opened. We took school supplies. Every child received school supplies. Over 200 people have accepted Jesus. And I believe in my heart that these adults and kids who have accepted Jesus as their personal savior would not consider selling their child anymore into sex slavery. They would begin, and they've begun to understand how precious their children are. When we got to Cambodia, there was nothing more than I can tell you, but we had an acceleration that was powered by the Holy Spirit, that we could do more, that we could be more, that we could touch more, and that God could use us to change the things around us that we could see with our eyes. So I want to encourage you today to believe that when you say yes to God, yes, I will go, yes, I will serve, He will rush to you with the power of the Holy Spirit, and you will never be the same.